7 o'clock. Good evening. Thanks for making time. So we're going to start the school board meeting with roll call and the Pledge of Allegiance. You want to start us off?
Jackie Ball, student representative.
Vernon Garland, school board.
Jim Morelli, school board.
Jesse Tyler, school board.
Ms. Holden, superintendent.
Eddie Wilson, school board.
Scott Wilson, school board.
Kelly Wilson, business administrator.
Thank you. Go to Pledge of Allegiance. So we want to take a moment of remembrance for Harry Gale, a true friend of some of the schools. Just take a moment. Thank you for that respect. We want to move to the approval of the board meeting minutes. We have two sets of minutes. The minutes from the April 4th, 2018 school board meeting, and the minutes of the April 18th, 2018 SCS facilities meeting. Motion to approve the minutes.
Make a motion. For the school board minutes of April 4th, 2018.
Okay, motion by Jim, second by?
Second.
Ed? Any discussion? No discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. The next set of minutes, the April 18th, 2018 SCS facility meeting, they're also included. I have a motion to approve those minutes.
Make a motion to approve the minutes of April 18th, 2018, the SCS facility meeting.
Motion by Ed, do I have a second? I was at the meeting.
I was too.
So I can second as a participant of the meeting, so I'm going to second those. That opens it up for discussion. You and Russ are the only other attendees, so any just discussion points you want to have on those notes?
I thought it was a good meeting.
Yeah.
Yep, that was good, it was productive.
Yeah, good meeting, and the notes were solid. So with motion by Ed, support, second by me, we had all in favor. Sorry, I went out of order. Dang it. I'm gonna try again. Take two, scene two. Motion by Ed, seconded by me. No discussion, no further discussion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
I do this so folks at home can see.
Abstentions, if you weren't there?
Yeah, I missed the abstentions.
Abstentions.
Mine too. I'll work on the abstentions. Note to self. Thank you. Moving to the agenda review. So we have one addition on the action items with the resignation letter, which we'll talk about. And then one deletion, which was the round trip. All right. Public forum. So this is a 15-minute forum, 3 minutes each. Anyone want to step forward to comment? Seeing none? Not seeing one, but now seeing one.
I would just request to speak with a lot of it.
Sure. All right. So we'll go with, I do facilitation at Hypertherm.
Yeah.
And we go with, this isn't, I like what you're saying or not, but this is, I got you, I'm clear or loud enough, so I'll try to check a little bit. I usually have a booming voice, so I was trying to be polite, so I'll be less.
I hear you.
Less demure.
I hear you.
I'll give a little more gas to it. Thanks for speaking up, because other people probably are feeling I just wanted to throw in a comment from what a few of us did last night. Jim, Scott, and I attended the school board training for new board members, and I went to a separate training for new chairs last night. We got a wealth of information, a book, a packet, and a lot to digest, but it was really helpful, really insightful. It's kind of exciting. So I just wanted to share in your faith in us that we're investing as well and taking advantage of some of those resources. And as we settle in as a new board, I want to thank the community's ongoing support of the schools, the budget, most importantly, the kids and the education and the staff of the schools. And so that it's stated, and I might state at every meeting, we're all a group of individuals. So we're going to have our different opinions, and that's a wonderful thing in democracy. We need to have productive debate where it's beneficial and moves us forward. It's great when we're all in agreement, and it's great when we're not. So I just wanted to set the tone and really encourage the board for this next year. Any questions you have, ask them. And if you're not asking questions, you might get a friendly nudge from your chair to ask more, so that we can keep the dialogue more and more open. It makes us better as a board, and it's beneficial for the community that's entrusting us. So I just wanted to set the tone as we get started. Next item is a presentation from the STEAM team. James McDonald, Scott Gamgee, and Kirk.
Turn and look in the corner, those orange kits over there are primary in, material cardboard and duct tape. Encourage you to check it out. Which are exhibits? Here you have, we're going to come back to this too, with some treasure shades that would go with the elementary school kids combined with the Strauss program at the middle high school as well. So we're going to come back to that. Yeah. Now, it's got good. I'm going to turn this over to James now, and he's going to talk about support is engineering.
Hi everybody, I'm Jim McConnell. My name is Jim McConnell. I've been developing our computer science and engineering classes at the middle high school. The following classes are offered at the middle school level. We incorporated a middle school computer science. It focuses on the understanding of the essential facts, concepts, and principles and theories relating to computer science and software applications. Seems kind of high level for middle school, but basically what we're doing there is we're looking at some block programming. So we use, this is an app lab thing which we use from code.org. This is just an application that they made. It's basically a quiz, and I can't see it too well, but yeah, so they check this and it will just create a quiz. So we do some block programming. We also use some Python, so a little lower level programming. We created some like art through programming. They kind of learn that it's not simply just slide an object on and poof your images there. There's actually a lot of stuff that goes into actually just creating this little penguin. That's probably like a week and a half's worth of typing and putting in information and figuring out where everything goes. We also, in that middle school computer science class, we did some programming with VEX. We've actually invested quite a bit at the school in VEX robotic stuff. So we use that equipment in middle school computer science class just to program the Cortex to operate different sensors. At this class, we didn't actually run any of the motors with it. We just used the programming part to get the stuff running, but we didn't build anything to make it. That wasn't the focus for the computer science program. So there's computer science at the middle school in introduction. Next slide. Okay, then we also have a gateway to engineering class at the middle school, and we've actually implemented a project lead board curriculum into the middle school and high school. Within the project lead away gateway engineering, we've only really focused, we only have that class for one semester, so we've chosen to use the design modeling and automation. So in the design and modeling, we use Autodesk, Inventor, to do some modeling, so we just do some basic 3D modeling, revolving, extruding, getting used to those terms that are used within engineering and development, design kind of things, lofts, things like that. And also in that class, we do some automation stuff. They get into using some mechanisms, and then actually we're going to be providing the mechanisms using a microcontroller. So there's actually some kids in this current class that has some experience with the programming one, which will probably do extremely well with that. So that's the gateway to engineering class. Okay, now at high school level. At the high school level, we focus. At the high school level, we have a computer science class, where the focus is to think algorithmically and solve problems efficiently using a computer. So this is at the high school level. This is open to anyone from 9th to 12th grade. Our topics are abstraction and algorithms. I don't have an image for this one, but what we primarily use is the language C. Some examples of the work, I don't have an image, but there's an awesome takeaway from this that I can share with you. There was one student in the class that actually kind of stumbled into the class, found interest in the class, got accepted to the university, he's going to go into the computer science field, and actually we looked up his classes that he would have to take for that. And one of the classes is programming with C, so it's going to be really cool to hear from him to see how he did that first semester with some experience, but I'm sure he'll do great. Another great takeaway from that class is a student was also able to take what he's been learning in that class, and he actually had a math models class, and he was modeling, he was programming out the problems that he was having in that math model class. For example, she was having them, there was like a chart of different locations of where the best place to put like a hot dog stand to get the most sale or something. So there's like a formula, different variables that would be associated with each location. And he was able to take those functions and those formulas and just create a simple program that he just entered in, put it in this location, and this will be your best one. You put it over here, this will not be your best one. So, makes sense? That's great. Okay. Okay, and then we also have an introduction to engineering design at the high school level. That again is a project lead the way class using that curriculum over there. So focus on engineering design process, applying engineering standards to hands-on projects. We do a number of design challenges, so they were presented with a problem, they use the design process to come up with the solutions. Here, just an example of the beginning stages of the design process. There's this brainstorming process, which I kind of really work with them, that it's not just quickly jump to the solution, but there's actually this huge brainstorming thing that comes out in the beginning. So we start with that, and we can narrow it down to our best possible solutions. So we do that multiple times. Although they think they get it after the first two, it's actually a learning thing, and it's a long process. So we do that. We've also done in that class some mechanisms as well, and did a toy pulley mechanism where they pull the object and it moves rotary motion, linear motion, so it's going from this way to now up and down. We do this at the middle school, or I did do that. Do this in the middle school, but I pulled it into the high school because these students didn't have that in middle school. So I'm really looking forward to the middle school kids coming up and seeing what we can do with this, knowing that they've had experience in the past. I did some statics, built a bridge, thought of a plan, kind of worked on scheduling and sticking to a timeline. And we also have, at high school level, programming through game design. It's very similar to the introduction to programming class, except we use game design as our tool to learn programming. Basically, the outcome of that is to design a game, and we didn't include that in there. So basically, at this point, we just have a platform game where there's a bunch of platforms and the object has to jump on these and it detects like gravity, so it pulls itself down. There's that. And then computer integration, integrated manufacturing. Our focus on that is the manufacturing process, and topics I'm going to cover in that is we use the CNC machine, which the school just bought. It's a CNC router machine that the school just bought last year. So we use that programming we use that tool along with some CAM software to cut out different objects that could be manufactured. I gotta be honest, this machine came in kind of late in the game for the year, so I was kind of playing catch up, and that class started right at the beginning of September, so I was like, So I'm actually looking forward to next year when we do this, to get a little more under my belt on that, I guess. So we learned about profile cutting, pocket cuts, things like that with the CNC machine. Another thing that we do in manufacturing is we cover what a cell is in manufacturing. And here we have this virtual software through Project Lead the Way where we get this software where we can create a cell with a robotic arm robotic arm that's real, live, that they program it out, and then you send it to this real, actual robot arm that actually does the physical stuff. So just maybe something down the road. Okay. And then there's also automation inside of this. So in manufacturing, there's lots of automation. And one of the things we talked about is just self-guided vehicles. So we use the robotics to just have, we're simulating like in a factory setting, we have like a cart following line, going to the next cell. So that's what we use that for. Again, it'd be cool in the future to actually see the middle school kids introduced to this stuff. Get to this class and see what they can do with that. Okay. 20 more pages, almost. And the last thing we have is an electronics. Using the Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi is a little computer that students can plug things into and actually program them to do different things, and different sensors are tied in. And then also the electronics part. Focus on that is electronics, prototyping with breadboard, electronic components, and building simple circuits, soldering things up. I'm kind of trying to really pull in the physical science stuff, like Ohm's law, and calculating resistors and all of that stuff, which I'm actually, it's kind of cool that they say, we did this to find out, okay, then what's the resistance on the circuit? So it's going to be cool to kind of make those connections and work that out. So I probably talked way too fast, but are there any questions that is there anything that I brought to your attention that you want to ask me?
Yeah, Jim, really good question. So at the high school level, is it just one course that you offer, or is it pre-engineering? Is that what it's called, a pre-engineering course?
Yeah, so at the high school level, what we've done is we have two pre-engineering classes, Introduction Engineering Design, actually three. Introduction Engineering Design and Computer Integrated Manufacturing. That was this year. We also have a Principle of Engineering, which is we're going to flip-flop. So this year we'll have Introduction Engineering Design. That'll go away. Next year we'll do Principles of Engineering. Then that'll go, and then Introduction Engineering Design, and that'll come in. So that's kind of the way we're thinking.
Is there maybe like any electrical stuff in the future, like a class, like maybe a half a year in electrical and then a half in maybe environmental and the engineering side to even further it past where we're at now? Or?
Yeah, but time is everything. I mean,
sure.
Do that.
Yeah.
But I'm kind of like a little overwhelmed. There's so much coming at me.
Yeah, this is good stuff. I like this a lot. I think it's really good, and I think it's good that our children are getting this type of stuff. I think it's awesome.
I mean, my goal, our goal is to kind of like just take what we have and really like perfect it, get it down really well, so that the kids are coming in and getting something out of it, and show growth, show knowledge, and then maybe talk about adding some other things in. I know some of you is like, oh yeah, let's do this, do that, and this.
I'm wondering if you decide to go out on the board at some point to consider
six kids to show up and say, yeah, but I play basketball, baseball, and I ski. Oh, great, so you're going to come this week. You won't be here next week. And then you'll be here this. So that's not going to be really, you know, awesome. So I'm thinking, what? I bet you I would get kids if I said, all right, we'll do it. We'll start August 1st. And we'll just get through a bunch of stuff and we'll start a school year. Yeah. But yeah, that's definitely going through my mind. That's
yeah.
So maybe yeah. Compensation through the summer or
something.
But we need to recharge, that's for sure.
For sure.
Yeah.
I know you said that the one the CNC machine there is talking and waiting. Are we providing you with enough equipment and tools to adequately cover seven different classes? Is there anything that you're lacking for these kids?
I think for this machine, there's kind of a shop that's already created for some tooling to make that really kind of work well. And then the other, really the biggest thing is time, just making time to get this stuff down. I mean, I'm not saying I need to be an expert at this, and I don't want to be an expert at this because then I take all the learning out of it because I'm just showing them. How do I do that? Well, click this. How do I do this? I'll just put this together. I don't want to be an expert because then I am just doing that. Put that over here. But I feel the summer it's a little more time to get some things. So I think the engine push is just time. I think the resources are there.
Sure. So for in the middle school curriculum, as you know, it's because I have a middle school child. But
yep.
Are these optional courses or mandatory? Do we put everyone through them? What percentage of kids are you getting through that middle school curriculum?
I haven't like kept track of the numbers. They sign up for the middle school electives, but I think I probably see most of them through their middle school time. I mean, I have 18 of them that in there right now. They're all 7th graders, 2 8th graders. So I don't know how many are in the class of 7th grade.
36, 40.
The majority of middle school students, he teaches a couple of classes, but the majority of them have a 7th period block where they're elective, and that's one of the options that they have the availability if they. And that's something we work considerably with the students on.
Yeah.
Having, you know, there's so much that is prescribed, but having some areas that they can take in engineering class 1 year and potentially another one the next year, or somebody who's more driven with art, or somebody who's more driven with, we're actually looking at potentially having more foreign language next year in the block, but allowing them to do that.
Okay.
So most of them are choosing to do it elective. There are more high school classes. There's a couple of high school classes where some students have to access some of the things that happens.
Are any of the, you say you're hoping in the high school courses you'll have the middle school students come up. Any of the courses actually have prerequisites where you have to have had a course beforehand, or can you go into all of them and start from scratch?
You can just start out. I mean, the project leading way curriculum, it works best if they're exposed to stuff a little earlier, like going over the mechanisms and the different motions and the different, you know, ears and ear brains. It may be cool to get that stuff out of the way early, but that doesn't mean that they would be lost. To answer your question, no, they don't. There's really no prerequisite. And actually, it's kind of cool because you usually get somebody in there that did do it in the middle school. Classes and they, I gotta learn more about this because it's kind of all new to College Board.
that's what could give our kids a definite advantage, right? When we want them to get these three classes at this point.
Yes.
If they apply for job IEP, that'll be a distinct advantage.
And actually, not to keep rambling, but there's a student in my introduction engineering design class right now, and she's going into mechanical engineering. I said, oh, where are you going? She's like, UNH, or Southern New Hampshire, or whatever the place is called. So we looked it up online, and we went to the engineering, and right there is like 3D modeling, statics. There's all the things that we've kind of done that we would do probably the way through principles of engineering and introduction engineering. So that's kind of cool to see. And actually, since I found that kind of on my agenda next year at the beginning of engineering class, like, look, I'm preparing you to go to this university to take all of these classes. So I know you think it's only a half a credit, but I'm sorry, we're going to push. So I don't want to send you off to this place and have you walk in.
And they're actually even selling frets, and they've got the mend devices, and they're can stand it all back up, put it there permanently. But it looks like hopefully this summer the lights will be moved out of that section, and maybe even the sprinkler system, we're hoping. And we can gain maybe close to 2 feet in height. And we have a 9 foot wide door. I think we'll be in pretty good shape at that point. This is 8 feet long, 7 feet wide, so we can go quite a bit wider. And it's, it must be about 8 feet tall. And this is what I hope you can buy. So I wanted a large scale, and I like this system because it's half plasma table and half wood CNC router. So you can actually like build a whole chair. You know, the side rails have wood, and then right over to the other side and cut out steel seat area that would fit into it.
So I think STEAM really presents different pathways for not just girls, but for all our kids, that part of us investing in this program is doing that. It's showing kids there are different paths to get potentially the way you want to be, and it doesn't mean you just have to get out and spend $50,000 a year on college. So I think it's changing that mindset.
I actually think you just said what I was going to discuss pretty well on that. And I was going to talk more about not necessarily the art department, which I did last year with school, but how not a class for a long day. How not necessarily having to have a STEAM class. You know, STEAM is not just a class. You could be in any class in school or any other activity. And I think that's where we're talking about is getting that up to maybe other populations, girls, boys, maybe kids that might not even like that or don't know they don't like it because they haven't taken a class. But if you're sitting in one of my art classes or a digital art class, I'm going to be doing art, yes, but I'm also doing, technology piece is definitely there. You know, there's going to be some building parts to it. There's going to be some engineering. And I think that's where we're looking at the STEAM is, those three things of the five letters. To be in that, we just have to point that out more in those classes. I always think back to my pottery class. I had a great ceramics class. And ceramics is one of the oldest forms of art, but it has science in it. You know, it has blaze chemistry. It has engineering. It has to be building. It has technology. You know, it might be old technology, but it's still technology. So building that and pointing that out in every class that we can, maybe we'll push that further down. Because right now, this population, like the girls, they're behind the computer at home. You know, my son's always talking about that gamer girl, that's kicking his butt on a video game somewhere. You know, they're there, but they're quiet, they're behind them. So if we start pointing it out in all the classes, or as many as we can, then I think they get that taste, that feeling, and might want to take that class at some point, or might be able to feel comfortable, maybe not at some point, but years ago. So that's where I'm thinking. Integrating, this STEAM type of model as much as we can. I try with the arts, any teacher needs some help, I'll go and they'll hey, have an idea here, have an idea there. We're running an open room where I feel like kids and teachers can come down and use my, not only my supplies, but my understanding of what they want to do and help them out that way. You know, I don't think integration necessarily means that two teachers have to be in the same room. But that they can work together, come up with ideas, use different educational ideas to bring forward, a common goal. You know, that's just not one way to go about doing that. So, and I'm always looking, to do that with teachers, students, staff, anybody who wants to, community members at any time. So I think that's one of the ways I think we're looking at the STEAM model to be jumping, forward. So,
can we touch on the community class?
Sure.
And I'll just want to ask things a little bit, so this is a new class that the child and Mr. Romain are going to do, and we look at how are we getting students in to the STEAM classes and how we keep that interest. This elective was developed because people who don't see themselves working in the shop, right, or working with some of this equipment or working in computer science, this was sort of a way to create a high interest entry point for people who don't necessarily see themselves in the classes we saw listed. And so Mr. Lejeune and Mr. Romain have taken this on, and we have high enrollment in selective with a lot of girls because we framed it around community service, right? Taking art and combining it with production and design and collaboration in the shop space. And so that's going to give so much exposure to those kids who might not have signed up for a class that was called woodworking during the period. So it's still in its formative stages, but high interest from students as a high schooler.
That's better to the parents too, for them.
Yeah.
Reach and what you've done in just a couple of years, what we've done, the staff and crew has done is pretty awesome. You put us against other schools that are, bigger, newer buildings, more space, bigger populations, we have some, that will have to be really proud of. So.
If I could throw, I'm going to throw another plug in too for something. I belong to the Computer Science Teacher Association for New Hampshire, and I meet with them, we meet like every 3 months, different locations. And I just want to put on the record that actually some of these only, I mean, there's really only like 6 really active schools in New Hampshire that are meeting in this group every 3 months. So I just want to put that out there on the record that some of these is actively involved and knowing what's going on with the state and the whole computer science movement. I know that I think it was Scott that talked about like competitions with computer science, and I thought maybe it was, but there's, but we've learned like there's ways that students can actually take what they've learned and actually go to these challenges like at certain colleges and stuff. So I'm just putting a plug in there that that's happening too. So.
And if they're, I guess, doing any activities, that information filtering for students and parents.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. And I know that.
So the last part is not to lose it, because I think it was an important piece. I was talking about, you know, to think, to create, to collaborate, design, manufacture, and one of the pieces you took tonight was about the plasma CNC machine. We've been able to sell off some of our old lathes, and Scott said they're raffling off
20 or 50
tickets. We got a meeting house, so hopefully people will invest in that. But we'll also have the ability for some that they're looking to either get a donation or naming or just gifting to be able to put that plasma cutter into our school, because that's part of developing this program. As we have a wood machine, having that metal machine and that plasma cutter in our school is available, where kids can program. So it's not just necessarily about when we took a wording class, we cut a piece of wood, you glue it together, this is now programming. This is that the higher end functioning jobs are available. And so giving our kids those opportunities in high school is just giving them again a great benefit down the road, hopefully to other opportunities, bigger and better opportunities. So naming rights, donations, definitely buy a raffle ticket, nothing else, and maybe you win yourself a nice reading night. And I just want to thank four of these guys that did a good job.
Yeah, great discussion, okay. Great update. Thanks very much.
Can I just ask one more thing?
Yeah.
Dartmouth does a phenomenal open house for engineering. I don't know if you guys have ever been, but if you can make that a mandatory trip for your students. I've taken my kids the last 2 years, and it's just phenomenal. You spend, they have, I don't know, 30 stations set up, and it's a 2.5 hour. We never get through all the stations because you get chatting with the folks. And it's geared towards itsy-bitsy little kids where they're making cotton candy to... one fellow has developed a mind detection machine. So the breadth of the education is phenomenal. Take my son, he's in one of the rooms and he sees math, he's down here, son of a, on a whiteboard in one of the engineering rooms, and he goes, huh, so this is how you use it. You know, it's, if you get the chance to make it a school field trip, I would highly suggest it.
Just checking.
It's a Friday
meeting. Yeah. So we have most of the year to get ready.
Yeah, no, so the school sent out a note this year saying if they had enough interest, they'd send the bus up. Well, I just don't know if they had a lot of interest, unfortunately. So, okay, on the engineering side, because all the tools that you outlined, they're all in the Dartmouth basement being used as part of the demonstration, so it's pretty solid.
I mean, the school's been great, but it's really the you know about those things, and bring those things to them is super important.
Yeah.
I think time is like each year grow a little bit better. Yeah.
Great. Thank you so much. It's a wonderful program. Wonderful.
Yeah. All right. Thanks.
As soon as you guys are done with Jack, you're going to be here for the color.
Yeah, so everyone, I'm going to shift quickly to the school update, starting with the student representative, who is then going to color run out of here. Okay.
So speaking of the color run, if you guys would like to do that, the seniors will be putting that on with the help of the juniors. This Saturday at the beach, it starts at 9, so if you'd like to come between 9 and 8 to register, you still can. Or if you want to sign up tonight, you can do that online. In other news, we had senior project night. All the seniors presented, and I believe everybody made the
for our Destination Imagination teams to make their plans to go to Globals if they won states. And the elementary school service learning team, S to the power of six, did come in first place in the state, so they'll be heading to Globals in Tennessee. Our kindergarten orientation is next Friday, May 11th. We've got fifth grade Nature's Classroom yard sale next Saturday, May 12th. The fifth graders hold that yard sale to earn money to support their trip to Nature's Classroom in sixth grade. On Friday, May 18th, the Sunapee Elementary School Chorus will be performing the national anthem at the New Hampshire Fisher Cats game. And then on May 31st will be our student showcase, which rolls several events into one. We will be having math games because we had to cancel our math night due to weather back in March. It's also the art show, prize speaking, and band and chorus concerts that night. So a full evening of events. But getting everything in one night to save families some time.
I can't hold it. That's great. Thanks for the update. Good. Any questions? Thanks. Appreciate it. The middle high school update.
Jackie mentioned our senior project presentation night. Again, this year, the Sunapee Lions Club did a scholarship supper prior to the commencement of the presentations. We so appreciate their continued support with the scholarships for that. In April, we had Alcohol Awareness Month, or week, that was led by Mr. Latora and his students in health class. So Lieutenant Cobb from the Sunapee Police Department came and gave a talk to the students about the effects of drinking and driving. Students also had an opportunity to use impairment goggles and try to drive a golf cart through a course, and a number of different public service announcements happened. We had a middle school activity night as opposed to a dance for one of the evenings in April that was well received. We really appreciate the support from Salt Hill Shanty. They did a dinner where they donated a portion of the proceeds to our service club, and that was well attended by staff and families. Mr. McDonald mentioned the Girls Technology Day. We took 20 students. We filled all the slots available to our school and headed to the Girls Technology Day, and appreciate Hypotherm putting that on. Ms. Bergen mentioned the elementary school team having DI success, and we had two middle school teams this year. One was coached by Mr. McDonald, and we had another team coached by Mrs. Julie and Mrs. King, and that team placed first at the state level and will go on to global finals for their fifth time, global finals. We've also started a new club, a biking club, that Mr. Lejean has begun, trying to generate some student interest and find a way for kids who aren't committed to a spring sport to just have a way to get outside and connect in a different way. And so that's getting going. And so it's just interesting, you know, Mr. McDonald spoke about, oh my gosh, I have 7 classes that I'm prepping for. And that's not typical. If you're from a larger school, you might have some, you know, you teach 1 or 2 classes several times a day. And sort of Sunapee style, you're teaching 3, 4, 5 different classes that you prep for. And in addition to that, you have Mr. Romain coaching the JV softball team and helping out with varsity softball. You have Mr. Lejean doing fight club. And you have Mr. McDonald coaching the team. So certainly Sunapee style.
That's great.
Thanks.
Yeah, I think it's great to call out where some of the crossover is and the mix of different things that some of the staff are involved with. We're all used to it, or we can be used to it, but I think it's good to call it out. I just had a question for both of you relating to DI. So we mentioned global, like, is this like ordinary? Are there like no other competitors, and we just, and everyone marched us through? Like, how uncommon or uncommon is it for a little school to be sending?
So we've been sort of dubbed Dynasty, like D-I-N-A-S-T-Y, this group of middle schoolers that since they were in third grade has had some pretty specific success.
Right.
You know, they've come in 7th, 7th, and 2nd in the world. So they get earned even some attention at the meet